Hi everyone and welcome to another daily video from Shopify Dropshipping Lifestyle. It's not technically a daily video, it's just serious to say. Today's video is a helpful one, believe it or not, about how to better track your Facebook ad conversions, okay? Alright, let's get straight into it. So this one is one that comes off the back of, I'm sure many of you have had this, where your Facebook ads aren't attributing sales. Now, many of you, I'm sure, are using TrackFi. I use TrackFi and it works very well. And it definitely helps with increasing the sales that gets put in the ads manager. But unfortunately, it doesn't do everything. And it is a pain because at times you don't know where the sales are coming from, and obviously the less information we have, the less informed. So I've been doing some research, and because I've been getting more into Google Ads, more into Google Merchant Center, and they're working well, still, you know, very much in the early phase of where I need to be. But one of the other big tools I've been using that a lot of people don't use for e-commerce much is Google Analytics. To be fair, is probably one of the best tools out there that you can actually get. And it's free and it does so much. The automated reporting, it's just, I can do an entire course on it. It's just ridiculous. But today we're doing in the URL parameters, okay? Now, I've made a simple sheet and I'll share this. All you have to do is, you used to have a spreadsheet. And the spreadsheet, you would make, you know, like five columns, and then you'd make the sixth column a formula where it would add, you know, the unique variables in. So UTM campaign equals, and then you could change that to from CPC to, I don't know, CPM or Google, or sorry, impression, sorry, or UTM source being Facebook, Google, Bing, Instagram, UTM campaign. And then you'd have to manually do that, and you'd have to do that for everyone. Facebook, I don't know, but about 6 months ago, I believe they released, dynamic tags, okay? Dynamic UTM parameter tags, which is extremely useful, okay? So all I have to do is give you guys this, and you just copy it into your ad. Now, let me just show you how this works. If we go back in the ads manager, one of my ads manager thing. You just literally go in here, fill it out like you normally do, how I've always said, and then you just put it in the UTM URL parameter. So if we just go here again, whoops, copy, paste, done. That's it, okay? That's it, blah, blah, ignore that. Now, if you are curious as well, you can, this is where you can actually change it, see how it then pulls that in. Campaign name, source, you can tell that is then correct. Ignore this, blah, blah, will be set to name. So because it's using a variable, so it's going to pick up the campaign name. So what that means is of this one, it's going to say WC test hat campaign. It's going to say the ad set is that, and it's going to say the ad is default name conversions. Now, I must admit, I'm not the best with my naming conventions of sometimes. So it's going to say WC blah, it's going to give me the ad set name and the ad name, okay? And what that's going to do is it's then going to push it into Google Analytics. It's going to show up. You can actually look at it in your real time. Sorry, I've had a long day. and it's 11:30 at night and I thought I'd record this for some reason. But you'll be able to see the medium and the source and the active users, okay? The medium being the name, the source being the destination, let's say Facebook. And you'll see active users. So you can actually see, so what we should see based off what I have here of the name convention is we're going to see that it's going to be called CPC, it's going to be called Facebook, and then it's going to get the dynamic name updates. And every ad, I suggest you do that in your every ad. So then you have it, okay, and you can have a look, and that's what you need to do. What we'll then also do is if you go under acquisition, if you go under all traffic, source medium, it should then also store it in here for future analytics, okay? So then you can, it technically defines that as a campaign, and you can look at the analytics from Google Analytics, okay? Now, trust me when I say that having a look at Google Analytics gives you a far more accurate perspective. Facebook, just a few days ago for me, had some serious issues with thousands of dollars worth of sales that was not attributed on the day. As a result, you know, like my ROAS took a massive beating. And as a result, I would have possibly killed some ads that may not have been needed to be killed. And it's stuff like that that really pisses me off. And I'm sure it pisses you all off. So I wanted to give this video... Jesus Christ. I wanted to give this video just to give some help, okay? I'll put a link down below. Just copy it. And as I said, you know, just use this. Just that simple, and it'll teach you something about Google Analytics, okay? You'll see in there, you can see your conversion rate, you can see, you do have to make sure in your Shopify store that you have e-commerce, enhanced commerce, I think they call it, enabled. If you don't, that's under your settings in your Google Analytics anyway. I believe it's under e-commerce, you just tick a tick box, and that's it. And then you get the e-commerce analytics. And it is important because the reason that you need to use Google Analytics that a lot of people aren't using it, and I'm using it more and more, admittedly I should be using it more than I am, is if you go under source medium, just as a tip anyway, you're going to see some amazing results, okay? So like for me, FOMO gets me sales. Messenger, you're going to actually see the messenger and the conversion rate. So like my messenger conversion rate for the band cart is 13%. Okay, 13% generates me thousands. FOMO, 9%. You know, and then you're gonna find organic keywords, and you might start doing Google AdWords, and then like these organic keywords that are converting randomly, you'll put it in your Google Ads, and it's like, bam, sales, more sales. And so using Google Analytics is very important. So you should never forget it. And this is just a little tip, little way to try and help understand Google Analytics a bit more and understand your Facebook analytics. Don't discount the importance of this stuff, okay? It is really important. Now, I'm going to leave it there for today. So I've got shit on my phone. It's really annoying me. And apparently, I'm super tired. I need to go to bed. Just for those wondering, went last few days. It's been just ridiculous with trying to keep up with work. Q4. You know, getting like 15, 20, oh my God. Oh, and you know, went for a long drive today. My partner's up in Sydney and I'm just absolutely knackered. Frankly, I don't even know why I made this video. I am so tired. I better go to bed, guys. I'm sorry. As I said, I will, there'll be a link in the description. Completely free, of course. Just download or open it, make a copy, use it, and you're all good. Alright, so I'm going to go to bed. My eyes are actually hurting right now. My eyes are hurting. If you did like today's video, hit the subscribe button. If you also liked it, don't forget to like the video. If you didn't like it or you want to comment on any feedback, comment down below, positive or negative, it doesn't matter. You know, I'm not the type of person that gets offended by a bit of negative feedback. I take it purely on board. In fact, we all sort of need feedback. It helps us to improve, okay? But aside from that, again, if you are interested, there's a cheat sheet down below. Completely free cheat sheet. Just download it. It really is so helpful. I'm thinking of making like a little video to sort of explain a little better for people in the future. But yeah, I'm going to head off. Thanks very much, guys. I am just so, so tired. See ya.